My name is Lex Baillie. I'm the Chief Inspector from the National Missing Persons Unit of Police Scotland. I'm standing here today outside Police Scotland at Dalmarnock. On a daily basis, we deal with missing people and implement the policy across all our local divisions to support each and every investigation that takes place. On average, Police Scotland deal with approximately 440 missing person incidents every week. That breaks down to 63 missing person investigations every single day of the year. Every missing person report is acted upon immediately from the moment that the police are informed of it. We may well put officers on the street immediately, or indeed we may well take a bit of time to research the police systems to identify this particular area for us to carry out our work. Whether it's 101 or by dialing 999 or by even physically attending at a police station, it's very important that we are informed of a person who's missing as quickly as possible. 101 will be treated just the same way as a 999 call if the risk identified for the person is serious enough. We'll take a number of details. We'll take basic details for a start: name, address, date of birth, age, employment status, where they work. We'll also look for a physical description to be passed over, maybe even a photograph of the person. We'll look for any habits, mannerisms, any associates that they may have, who their friends are, who they're likely to be. We'll also ask about any vulnerabilities. Depending on the nature of the investigation, we'll call on any resource that would be required to carry this investigation fully. We'll have local officers carrying out work on the ground. We'll have the dog unit, helicopter, the marine unit to search in water-based areas. We'll have detectives if there's criminality suspected. We may well even call on the support unit to bring out fingertip searches. We've also got the use of the force helicopter as well. The number of untraced persons we have in Scotland is very, very small. From April to December 2016, we carried out 17,000 missing person investigations. Of that, only 15 are still outstanding, and work is still ongoing to try and trace those individuals. We've a number of long-term missing people dating back to 1957 with the Moy Anderson case, which has had a high level of publicity recently. We will treat every investigation as an investigation. We will not close the door on any long-term missing person. You know, one case that springs to mind is a case from Grampian Police. A male was reported missing in 1990, some 26 years ago, and despite the inquiries being carried out at the time, wasn't traced through financial investigation, through cross-border sharing information with our colleagues across various forces and intelligence gathering, that we identified that he'd been found safe and well some 26 years later. Sandy Davidson's really quite a vexing case for us. He was a young boy reported missing from Irvine when he was just a toddler. He wandered out the garden and never came back. We still remain that this case remains open at this time. We still have his picture on our website. We've even done a mock-up to try and identify what Sandy would look like today, some 40 years after he's initially gone missing. But we will keep that case open until we find definitive proof that Sandy is safe and well.